Hello everyone, this is your pal Nick Kick 2001 here. After I watched this movie, all I have to say is, even I love Tenet, it's one of the best movies of 2020. I think Exception is way better than Tenet, So anyway guys, and today I'll do a movie review of Exception, came out the year from 2010. Alright guys, I got the plot ready, let's get the plot, shall we? Basic plot is about Dom. Dom is still is a waste of accelerate to enter people's dream. And still the secret of the exceptions, get it, exception title. His skill has made him a hot comedian in the war of the combatant exceptions, but has also cost him everything he loved. Cost get a chance, a reception. His official is seeing impossible trash. And plan is the ideas of someone mind if he's someone exception, it would be perfect crime. But his dangerous enemy exception cost every move, and that's basically the plot is. Sorry guys, I didn't see this movie in theaters on July 16th because I was in my bad parents' house. But not this time, I'm talking about the other one with Bad Linda. She didn't take me to see that movie. So yeah, I was really upset. And yeah, I didn't see this movie in theaters back in 2010, yeah. So I watched this movie on Peacock. Yeah, I watched this movie on Peacock, except watching Harry Potter Part 2 because I had to pay for it. So I watched this movie on Peacock, and no joke, after I watched this movie on Peacock, it was a stupid commercial for no reason. So I just watched three part of it, so I didn't watch the full one. So I watched it all the way, and what did I think about this movie? I think this movie is one of my favorite movie by Christopher Nolan. Is this my favorite movie from 2010? Well, it's tied with Exception, and Tango will be my favorite movie from 2010. Yep, Exception tied with Tango, one of the best movies from 2010. It's way better than Despicable Me, I guess. But anyway, do you have any positive? Yeah, I have positive. I do have any negative. No, I don't have any negative. I don't have any negative at all. So anyway, let's get the story. The story is very entertaining. It's from a director who made Christopher Nolan. Christopher Nolan is such a fantastic director. Next to Jennifer Lee, Chris Buck, and Zack Snyder. Well, Christopher Nolan is such a great director who made Dunkirk. I haven't seen Dunkirk, so I'll watch it. And The Dark Knight, one of the best movies from 2008. And he did a great job directing sections, so yeah. Let's get the character, shall we? I know every character. White Cop, played by Renato Tolmanen. If you know him, he was in The Wolf of Wall Street. Honestly, I haven't seen that movie. And, Titanic. To be honest, guys, I have not seen Titanic, but because it's really a freaking 3 hours movie, and I'm not wasting my time 3 hour movie watching Titanic. I have a romantic stuff, so anyway. But don't get me wrong, Titanic is such a great movie, but I'm not gonna watch it because it's freaking 3 hours, and I just don't want to watch a movie 3 hours one time. Alright, so anyway, the action scene worked pretty cool, and all the characters, like Arthur, he's great. Anubis, who played by Tom Hardy, who played by the same guy doing Venom and Boom and Mad Max. And that's all the character I know. And do you know the character who's the voice of Alfred? He's in every Christopher Nolan movie Exception, The Dark Knight, Dark Knight Rises, Dunkirk, Tenet, yup. He's in every Christopher Nolan movie. So Michael Sarn, you did a great job, man. You did a great job. And the action scene looked pretty cool. And the visual effect, and the cinematography, and the direction, and the producer, great job making that movie. I think my favorite scene of this movie, not in the climax scene, when they have a war tearing down, and have an epic fight scene. Oh man, I really like the fight scene in that movie. Alright, so guys, I have nothing to say about Exception. So overall, guys, Exception is tied with Tango, one of the best movies from 2010. This is way better than Orca Mega. We can get screwed on movie because the movie sucked a bunch of balls. So anyway, this movie is next to Tangled, Toy Story 3, Rango, Legend of the Guardian by Zack Snyder, one of the best movies from 2010. And I'm going to say again, this movie tied with Tangled, one of the best movies from 2010. Exception is my new favorite Christopher Nolan movie ever, and Frozen 2 Fantastic Four will agree with me. And I am proud to get, I'm going to give Exception a 10 out of 10. This is epic, brilliant masterpiece, and this movie deserving a seal of Nick Hick awesomeness. Yep, I'm no longer doing that thing. Oh, yeah, it's very annoying. So I'm just making my the bad movie for the bad movie is a seal of Nick Hick garbage, but this movie is getting a seal of Nick Hick awesomeness. Ding ding ding. Great job, Christopher Nolan in 2010. Great job, because this movie is such a fantastic movie. Even I didn't watch the movie, because I really want to watch Space Jam 2 movie, see how bad it is. Alright, so guys, that was my movie review of Exception. Tell me what you thought on Exception. It's one of the best movies from 2010. Or just like everyone else who don't care about this movie, thinks this movie is huge, overrated. Alright, come below. Let me know. I hope inside if you guys want, don't hate this movie. I swear to God, if he hate this movie, I'm just going to be speechless and say, what is wrong with you? Seriously, you hate Tenet, and now you're going to hate this. You better not hate this. I swear to God. Alright, so guys, no, excuse me. I'm going to watch Space Jam 2 The New Legacy. Maybe see how bad it is, because people say it's bad, it's boring. So I heard a mediocre review for Space Jam 2, so anyway. Alright, so anyway, guys, stay tuned for my Space Jam 2 review today, and I hope you enjoy my Exception review. I hope my review don't sound boring. Alright, so guys, my Exception review is coming to a close, and I'll see you on my next video, my Space Jam 2 review. And I don't have a crush on Rose Bunny in the sequel, or in the first movie. Alright guys, see you next time. So long. Peace, YouTube!
What would I do without you? You'll always have me.